Dr. M.C. Sundaraja. He completed his undergraduate studies from Madurai Kamaraj University and went on to complete his master's in structural engineering from the same. He is a doctorate from Anna University and he's also done his postdoctoral fellowship at the Queensland University of Technology, Australia. He has more than 17 years of experience in the teaching profession and he has also published papers in 39 international journals, 7 national journals, 27 international conferences and 51 national conferences. He has so far published 124 papers in various journals. He went on to receive the Best Research Paper Award from IFERP, a unit of VVERT and NIAR on 4th April 2015. He has also received Outstanding Faculty Award from the Venus International Foundation Faculty Award, VIFFA, in the year 2015. Currently, Dr. M.C. Sundaraja is now working as an assistant professor in Thyagarajar College of Engineering, Madurai.
Welcome to UGC lecture series in bioarchitecture. In the previous lecture, we have seen the design of one-way continuous flow slab as well as roof slab, and also we have seen the reinforcement detailing. In this lecture, we are going to see the design of two-way slab, that is simply supported slab. If you design a two-way slab, that is a simply supported slab, it does not have any adequate provision to resist the torsion at corners. In the case of two-way simply supported slab, it is freely supported over the walls if it is freely supported on the beams. So, it is the four corners are lifted up. In order to resist the lifting up of slab at the corners or in order to resist the torsion which is developed at the corners, we need to separately design a corner reinforcement, that is called the torsion reinforcement at the four corners. So, in the case of two-way simply supported slab, there is a separate table which is given in the code book, that is table 27, which is used to design, which is used to find out the moment coefficient for the two-way simply support, for finding the bending moment for two-way simply supported slab. So, in the case of two-way simply supported slab, there are steps to calculate, steps to. First, we need to calculate the total load acting on the slab. First, before it, we need to check whether it is a two-way slab or not, or two-way slab or one-way slab. If you confirm it is a two-way slab, if it is a simply supported slab, first we need to first calculate the total load acting on the slab. Then, we need to refer the table 27 for finding out the bending moment at the various places, that is at the support as well as at the mid-span. And also, and using the maximum bending moment, we need to first find out the effective depth of the slab. And using the bending moments, so here we have find, since it is a two-way slab, the slabs are spanned along two direction. We need to find out the bending moment along both the direction, and we need to select the maximum bending moment for finding out the effective depth of the slab. But in the case of reinforcement, it is not like in the case of one-way simply supported slab. It is a two-way slab. We need to find out the reinforcement along both the direction on the respective bending moments, and also we need to check the depth of the footing against a deflection. Finally, we need to draw the reinforcement detailing of two-way simply supported slab. Now, we are going to work out some example. So, the first problem, analyze and design the reinforcement required for a two-way simply supported slab which is supported on all the four sides with the corners free to lift, or the slabs do not have any adequate provision to prevent the lifting of corners. The effective dimension of the room is 3.5 meter by 3.5 meter. It is supported on 230 mm thick wall. Live load on the slab is 3 kN per meter square, and consider other dead load also for the design. Use M20 grade concrete and Fe415 as the materials. Now, here the effective size of the room is, that is Ly by Lx, that is effective size of room Ly by Lx is 3.5 meter by 3.5 meter. The ratio Ly by Lx is equal to 3.5 meter by 3.5 meter, which is equal to 1, which is less than 2. It has to be designed as two-way slab. So, it is two-way simply supported slab. it does not have any adequate provision to resist the torsion at the corners. So, we need to find out the bending moment coefficient by referring a separate table, that is table 27 of IS 456-2000. So, before designing the thickness of the surface, we need to calculate the load which is acting over the slab, that is load calculations. So, first one is dead loads. Dead load, which consists of self weight of the structure itself and weight of the floor finish. In the case of this building, that is, it has effective dimension of 3.5 meter by 3.5 meter. Within this, we are not constructing any partition wall. So, we need to consider only the self weight of the wall as well as the floor finish as a dead load boundary. We are not going to consider any partition wall which is constructed inside the building. So, to find out the self weight of the slab, first we need to assume the thickness of the slab. This assumption is based on the deflection criteria. But here, we have normally, in the case of simply supported slab, we have followed the deflection rule of, that is, L by D ratio equal to 20. It is for a simply supported slab, but a separate codal provision which has been given in IS 456 for the two-way slab with a condition, that is, the span of slab should not exceed 3.5 meter and the type of loading should not exceed 3 kilonewton per meter square. If the span of slab, that is a shorter span, if it does not exceed 3.5 meter and the type of loading which does not exceed 3 kilonewton per meter square, we can use the deflection controllers, that is L by D ratio, that is L by overall depth ratio as 35. If you use mild steel bar, L by overall depth ratio is 35. If you use deform bar, this value again reduced by my multiplying with the 0.8. This is a separate codal provision which is given in IS 456 for a two-way simply supported slab with a condition of the shortest span which should not exceed 3.5 meter and the loading class should not exceed 3 kilonewton per meter square. That is, L by overall depth ratio equal to 35, and further it has been reduced by 0.8 by multiplying with the factor, that is 0.8 for deformed bars. So, from this, D is equal to L divided by 35 into 0.8. Here, L is 3500. It is a square slab, 3500, but for rectangular slab, we need to select the shortest span for checking the deflection criteria. 3500 divided by 35 into 0.8, which is equal to 125 mm. So, I am going to keep D is equal to 125 mm as a overall depth of the slab. So, small d is equal to 125 minus 15 minus 10 by 2, which is equal to 105 millimeter. So, 15 is the clear cover, d, the 10 is the diameter of the reinforcement I am going to use for my design. So, here first one, self weight of the slab. In the case of dead load of the slab, self weight of the slab is the overall thickness of the slab, that is 150 into the unit weight of RCC, which is will be equal to 3.125, that is 3.. The overall thickness of the slab is 0.125, that is 125 millimeter, 0.125 equal to 3.125 kilonewton per meter square. And the weight of floor finish, that is equal to, here I am assuming a plain concrete floor finish, that is the thickness for a thickness of 25 mm and the unit weight of plain cement concrete is 24. So, 0.025 into 24 is equal to 0.6 as the weight of floor finish. Now, total dead load over the slab is WD equal to 3.725 kilonewton per meter square. And live load on the slab is given in the problem. Live load on the slab, that is WL, which is equal to 3 kilonewton per meter square. I think that 3 kilonewton per meter square is given in the problem. Now, total load on the slab, W is equal to 6.725 kilonewton per meter square. This is a total load on the slab. Next, second one, bending moment calculations. As I have already told you that there is a separate table, that is table 27 of IS 456-2000, which is used to find out the moment coefficient for the two-way simply supported slab for the ratio of Ly by Lx. Ly by Lx here it is 1, and the alpha x is the moment coefficient along x direction and alpha y is the moment coefficients along y direction. So, for x direction it is 0.062 and y direction it is again 0.062. This is the moment coefficient. For example, what do you mean by moment coefficients? Here for simply supported slab M is equal to WL square by 8 for a simply supported one way simply supported slab for which is subjected to an uniformly distributed loss. Okay, 1 by 8 is taken as moment coefficient. In similar manner, we have one finding and the moment coefficient along both the direction, that is x and s y direction for a simply supported slab which is do not have any adequate provision to resist torsion at corners. This is from table 27. Now, bending moment m x is equal to alpha x into W L x square, m y is equal to alpha y into W L x square. So, here both the expression we use L x, that is a short aspect that is most important. 0.062 into W is, that is here m x is equal to m y, that is W is 6.725 into 3.5 square. Here also 0.062 into 6.725 into 3.5 square, which is equal to 5.11 kilonewton meter. So, the bending moment along both the direction here it is this, it is 5.11 kilonewton meter. So, here m x is equal to m y is equal to 5.11 kilonewton meter, m u x is equal to m u y is equal to 1.5 into 5.11, that is equal to 7.665 kilonewton meter. Now, we need to find out next third step, effective depth of the slab. The effective depth of the slab by considering a balanced section, considering a balanced section and also 1 meter width of slab. Now, by when you consider is a balanced section, now we need to equate by equating m u maximum equal to m u limit. So, here m u is m u x equal to m u y, since both are same, that is which is equal to m u limit, which is equal to 0.138 f c k b d square, where d is equal to square root of 5, that is sorry, m u x divided by 0.138 f c k, that is equal to 7.665 into 10 to the power 6 divided by 0.138 into 20 into f c k b into 1000. So, d is equal to 52.70 millimeter, which is less than 105 mm, that is assumed value. So, hence it is safe against flexure. Now, I am going to keep the depth of the footing as, sorry, depth of the slab as 125 mm and small d as 105 mm in order to check the depth of the section against the deflection. I am again keeping d as 125 mm and small d as 105 mm. Now, I am going to find out fourth step, area of reinforcement. Since it is a square slab, the bending moment along both the directions are same or equal. So, along both the direction, mu x is equal to mu y is equal to 0.87 f y ast into d minus 0.416 x u. That is, we have this is the expression which is used to find out the area of reinforcement required for singly reinforced or under reinforced section, where a x u is equal to 0.87 f I a s t divided by 0.36 f c k into b. That is 0.87 into 415 into a s t divided by 0.36 into 20 into 1000. That is equal to 0.05 AST. Now, we need to substitute in the expression. I am going to form a quadratic equation, that is AST square minus 5047.97 AST plus 1.02 into 10 to the power 6 equal to 0. So, that is by substituting, that is the bending moment we have calculated as 7.665. 7.665 into 10 to the power 6 is equal to 0.87 into 415 into AST into D 106 or 105 minus 0.416 into 0.05 AST. By substituting this, I got this quadratic equation. By solving the quadratic equation, I got the lowest value as AST required, that is 210.87 millimeter square. Now, I am going to check this AST with the minimum AST. So, the minimum AST for deformed bars, it is 0.12% of cross sectional area of concrete. That is 0.12 divided by 100 into 1000 into 105, that is equal to 126 millimeter square, which is very less than 210.87 millimeter square. Hence, AST required for our design is 210.87 millimeter square. I am using 8mm diameter bar. Spacing of reinforcement, that is 1 meter without the slab, that is 1000 divided by 210.87, which is equal to 238.37 millimeter. I am going to check this spacing with the maximum spacing. Check for maximum spacing. So, for maximum spacing, that is a parallel main reinforcement should not exceed the least of the following, that is 3 into D, second one is 300 mm, that is 3 into 105, it is 315 mm, and the lesser value here it is 300 mm. So, I can adopt 8mm diameter at 8mm provide 8mm diameter bar at 200 mm center to center on both the directions. So, here finally, I need to check the depth of the section against deflection. That is the same as we have seen at the beginning, that is L by D ratio equal to 35 into 0.8. So, here D must be equal to 125 mm. For 125 mm thickness of the slab, the main reinforcement has to be provided as 8 mm diameter bar at 200 mm center to center. Now, we need to see that reinforcement detailing. So, here before seeing the reinforcement detailing, first we need to design the torsion reinforcement at four corners, that is torsion reinforcement. Since it is the two-way simply supported slab, this slab which do not have any adequate provision to resist torsion at corners. So, to avoid the or to prevent the lifting up of the corners, we must provide the reinforcement at the corners in the form of mesh reinforcement, both top as well as at the bottom, that is at the top two layers, at the bottom two layers. How to find out the area of reinforcement required for it at the corners to avoid the lifting up of the slab. As per IS 456-2000, the torsion reinforcement is equal to 3/4 of AST required for the main reinforcement. That is equal to 3/4 of 210.87, that is equal to 128.13 millimeter square. Now, using 8 mm diameter bar for corner reinforcement, I am using 8 mm diameter bar spacing of reinforcement at the corners, that is to avoid the lifting up of the reinforcement, that is pi by 4 into 8 square into 1000 divided by 128.13, that is equal to 390 mm, that is I am taking this as 300 mm center to center. So, this reinforcement has to be provided at the corners. Now, to provide the reinforcement required for it. So, here this is a slab, this is a square slab which is supported on four walls, thickness of the four wall is good. Now, to resist the torsion at the corners, this is the portion we need to provide the reinforcement, that is 8 mm diameter bar at 300 mm center to center, that is in the form of in along both the directions, that is both top as well as at the bottom. This is the corner reinforcement. So, here the reinforcement is 3/4 of the main reinforcement which has been provided for the slab for resisting the bending moment. But at what length it has to be provided? It is provided for a length of L by 5 along both the direction. This is L y by 5 and this is L x is by 5. Along with the reinforcement, that is this is the main reinforcement we are providing in the case of two-way slab. That is the reinforcement is also to be provided along both the direction. Alternate bars has to be cranked over the supports. So, here when you take the cross section, it is simply supported on walls. So, this is the cross section of the reinforcement. The bar has to be cranked at 0.1 L from the face of the support to avoid the tension at the top. So, here 50% of the reinforcement has to be provided at the top to resist the torsion to avoid the partial restraint which is developed at the support. And this is also the main reinforcement, but in the case of one way simply supported slab, this reinforcement will be normally distribution reinforcement, but here since it is a two way slab, the reinforcement along both the directions are the main reinforcement, that is this is the main reinforcement and this also main reinforcement, that is 8 mm diameter bar at 200 mm center to center. And this effective span of the slab is 3 meter, that is L. This is the cross section of the reinforcement and this is the plan view of the reinforcement. This is the plan view and this is the cross section. So, in the case of the two-way simply supported slab which do not have any adequate provision to resist the torsion, we need to provide the torsion reinforcement in addition to the main reinforcement at four corners in four layers, two layers at the top and two layers at the bottom. The area of reinforcement should not be and should be 3/4 of the main reinforcement which has to be provided, and the length of reinforcement from the face of the support from the end of the slab is L/5 on both direction. So, this is the design of the two-way simply supported slab for a building. So, we have also seen the cross section and the plan view of the reinforcement. So, after calculating the load, we have found the bending moment using the moment coefficients given in the table 27 of IS 456. So, that based on the moment coefficients, we have found the bending moment along both the directions. Since it is a two-way slab, there is a bending along both the direction. The reinforcement has to be provided along both the direction as the main reinforcement, and in addition to the main reinforcement, we have to provide the torsion reinforcement both corners as in the form of four layers. So, this is regarding the two-way slab that is simply supported slab. Now, I need to summarize this lecture. So far, we have seen design of two-way simply supported slab by using the moment coefficients given in table 27 of IS 456 2000, and also we have designed one slab that is using some work cut example, and the thickness of the slab as well as the reinforcement has been found, and also the reinforcement detailing completely discussed. And in connection with this, the questions, the other questions that is design a two-way reinforced concrete floor slab for a room of size 4 m/5 m subjected to a live load of 3 kN/m². This is the size of room is different. So, we need to find out the bending moment along both the direction by finding the moment that is bending moment along both the direction, and we need to find out the reinforcement along both the direction. So, here since the size is varying, the bending moment should also be varied and the reinforcement should also be varied. So, here the load due to the floor finish is 1 kN/m², and in addition to that partition wall load is 2 kN/m². For the design, use M20 and Fe415 as material. And the second problem, design the reinforcement record for two-way slab simply supported on all four sides with corners free to lift, or the slabs do not have any adequate provision to prevent the lifting of corners. The clear dimension of the room is 5 m/5 m. Here it is 5 m/5 m, so square slab. It is supported on 230 mm thick wall. A live load on the slab is 1.5 kN/m². In addition to this, they have asked us to consider other dead loads also. Use M20 and Fe415 as materials. And here, in connection with the references, we need to refer IS 456 2000, that is plain and reinforced concrete code of practice. To find out the load for rooms of different buildings, we need to refer IS 875. And in order to know the reinforcement detailing, we need to follow the SP 34/1987. And to discuss about more problems and the theory of these slabs, we can refer the reinforced concrete design by S.N. Sinha. And another book that is a well-known book which is written by Ashok K. Jain, that is the Reinforced Concrete Limit State Design. It is published by Nem Chan and Brothers. The first book which was published by Tata McGraw-Hill Publishing Limited. Thank you very much.